Today, I'm going to teach you how to fix one of the biggest reasons your fasting blood sugar stays high, even when you're eating well, taking your medication, or cutting carbs. That reason is liver fat. If your liver is storing excess fat, especially saturated fat, your liver cells become insulin resistant. And when the liver is insulin resistant, something detrimental happens. It continues releasing glucose into your bloodstream all night long. That's the main reason why your fasting glucose is high in the morning. Not because you ate carbs, but because your liver couldn't churn off its internal glucose faucet. So in this video, I'm gonna show you three scientifically proven ways to reduce liver fat and naturally lower your fasting blood sugar, all backed by real human trials, not opinions, not theories. So let's get into it. Let's start with the strongest evidence we have. Method number one, reducing saturated fat intake. One of the most powerful ways to reduce liver fat is to reduce your saturated fat consumption, especially from meat, eggs, cheese, butter, coconut oil, and processed foods cooked in animal fat. Why saturated fat? Well, saturated fat accumulates inside your liver cells and blocks insulin's ability to shut off glucose production. When that happens, your liver keeps dumping glucose into your bloodstream, even when you haven't eaten for 8 to 12 hours, leading to high fasting blood sugar. Now, let me show you one of the clearest studies we have on how saturated fat affects your liver. It's called saturated fat is more metabolically harmful for the human liver than unsaturated fat or simple sugars, published in Diabetes Care. Here's what the researchers did, and this is important. They took healthy adults and overfed them the exact same number of extra calories for 3 weeks. Same calories, same weight gain. The only thing that changed was the type of food those calories came from. The saturated fat group was given foods packed with saturated fat, including butter, blue cheese, and coconut oil. The unsaturated fat group got their extra calories from foods like olive oil, nuts, and pesto. The third group got extra calories from simple sugars. So remember, everyone was overeating equally. The only difference was what they were overeating. And here's the striking result. The saturated fat group stored twice as much liver fat as the unsaturated fat group, and significantly more than the sugar group too. They also developed worse insulin sensitivity and changes inside the liver that set the stage for metabolic disease. In simple terms, when the liver gets overloaded with saturated fat, it stops responding to insulin. And when your liver becomes insulin resistant, your fasting blood sugar shoots up, even if your weight stays the same. So yes, calories matter, but the type of fat matters dramatically more for liver health and fasting glucose. So it wasn't calories causing liver fat, it was the type of fat. This is extremely important for people with diabetes, because when you reduce saturated fat, your liver becomes more insulin sensitive, which means less overnight glucose release, lower fasting blood sugar, lower A1C, and better post-meal numbers. So here's what to do. Begin reducing saturated fat intake by lowering beef, pork, poultry, dairy, eggs, coconut products, and oils used for sautéing or frying. Replace those foods with beans, lentils, greens, fruit, whole grains, and vegetables. Low-fat, high-fiber foods don't store in the liver as fat. They help remove it. And if you want low saturated fat recipes to help reverse fatty liver, comment guide below and we'll send you our favorites. The second scientifically proven method is fasting or time-restricted eating. Why does fasting help? Because when you stop digesting food for a period of time, your body switches from storing energy to burning accumulated fat, including the fat stored in your liver. Now, let me show you a study that gives us real, measurable proof that time-restricted feeding, TRF, can help reduce liver fat. This was a 2025 randomized controlled trial published in Scientific Reports. Researchers took adults with metabolic associated fatty liver disease and split them into two groups. One group followed a 16-8 time-restricted feeding schedule and a DASH-style diet. The other group followed a standard calorie-restricted diet with normal meal timing. Both groups ate similar calories. Both groups lost weight. But here's the key. Only the time-restricted feeding group showed major improvements in liver health. After 12 weeks, the TRF group had a much bigger drop in liver fat, significant reductions in ALT and AST, two enzymes that rise when the liver is inflamed, and better improvements in liver stiffness and fibrosis. So why does TRF help the liver? Because when you extend the fasting window, your body switches from storing fat to burning stored fat inside the liver. The study explains that fasting increases fat mobilization, production of ketones, autophagy, insulin sensitivity, hormonal changes that support fat metabolism, and when you combine TRF with a diet that's naturally low in saturated fat and high in fiber, like the DASH-style meals used in the study, you create a powerful 1-2 punch for your liver. You're not just burning off the fat that's already in the liver. You're also stopping new fat from being deposited in the first place. And the results weren't subtle. In just 12 weeks, the TRF group saw a clinically meaningful reduction in liver fat, along with major improvements in liver enzymes and metabolic health. So, how do you actually practice TRF? Keep it simple. Choose an 8-hour eating window and stick to it. Most people do 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. or 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., but the exact hours aren't as important as being consistent. During your fasting window, stick to water, black coffee, or unsweetened tea only. And inside the eating window, focus on low-fat, plant-based, whole food meals so your liver isn't fighting new saturated fat while it's trying to clear the old fat. The timing plus the right foods equals the ideal environment for your liver to heal. If you want low-fat, high-fiber recipes that support liver fat reduction and better fasting blood sugar, comment guide below and we'll send them to you. Method number three surprises most people, and honestly, it's one of the most underrated. It's increasing your dietary fiber intake from whole plant-based carbohydrates. And unlike guesswork or weak associations, we actually have hard data on this. A new 2024 analysis of 5,935 Americans from the NHANES dataset used a direct liver fat measurement called CAP, controlled attenuation parameter. This is not a questionnaire. It's not a food frequency guess. It's a real scan of liver fat. And here's what they found. The more fiber people ate, the less liver fat they had, even after adjusting for BMI, age, sex, diabetes, cholesterol, and dozens of other variables. That means fiber itself is acting as a protective factor for the liver. This was especially true for women and white participants, where the inverse relationship was strongest, but the overall trend across nearly 6,000 people was clear. High fiber leads to lower liver fat. So how does fiber help reduce liver fat? Because high fiber foods naturally lower your intake of saturated fat, feed gut bacteria that produce short chain fatty acids, which improves insulin signaling, slow glucose absorption, reducing the burden on your liver, increase calorie density in your favor, improve insulin sensitivity in the liver and muscles, and that matters because when your liver becomes more insulin sensitive, your fasting blood sugar drops. Your liver stops dumping glucose all night long. So what should you actually eat? The most powerful, high-fiber, liver-friendly foods are beans, lentils, oats, chickpeas, berries, apples, greens, broccoli, whole grains like brown rice, quinoa, barley. These foods work because they help flush out excess fat inside your liver. Not in a detox tea kind of way, but by literally changing how your liver metabolizes fat and responds to insulin. Again, if you want our highest fiber, lowest saturated fat recipes designed specifically to reduce liver fat, comment guide below and we'll send them to you. Now let's talk about method number four, movement, but not any kind of movement. It's not high intensity training. It's not CrossFit or all out boot camps. I'm talking about zone two cardio, that low intensity, steady state movement where you can breathe comfortably, you can talk in full sentences, your heart rate is elevated, but not stressful. This zone is the sweet spot where your body burns fat as its primary fuel, including the fat stored inside your liver. And yes, we have a clean, gold standard study showing this works. In this randomized controlled trial by Sullivan et al., researchers took adults with fatty liver and assigned them to one of two groups. The first group was 16 weeks of moderate intensity aerobic exercise, 5 days a week, versus a control group that didn't exercise. Here's what's most important. They did not lose weight. Calories didn't change. Diet didn't change. Body fat didn't change. So we get to see the pure effect of exercise on the liver, independent of weight loss. The results? The exercise group experienced a 10% reduction in liver fat, lower ALT, a marker of liver stress, better metabolic function, all while their weight stayed exactly the same. So that means the benefit came directly from the movement itself, not from dieting. Moderate intensity aerobic exercise increases your liver's ability to burn fat, use fatty acids for energy, clear out triglycerides that keep fasting blood sugar high, and unlike high intensity interval training, zone two is sustainable. You can do it daily. You can actually feel good doing it. Keep it simple. 30 minutes per day, 3 to 4 days per week. Choose anything. Walking, an incline treadmill, cycling, swimming, elliptical. Keep the intensity light enough that you can breathe through your nose or hold a conversation. This is one of the most reliable, research-supported ways to lower liver fat independent of weight loss, which is exactly what improves fasting glucose. Let's bring it all together. If your fasting blood sugar is high, here's what you now know. Number one, your liver is likely insulin resistant. It's releasing too much glucose overnight. Number two, reducing saturated fat reverses this process. This is the number one driver of liver fat accumulation. Number three, fasting gives your liver a chance to burn stored fat. No eating leads to more fat oxidation, which leads to better insulin action. Number four, fiber-rich whole food carbs help clear liver fat. They lower saturated fat intake and improve insulin signaling. Number five, zone two cardio accelerates liver fat burn. No extremes needed. Put these together and liver fat begins to drop. And once liver fat drops, fasting glucose drops with it. If you want help putting this into practice, the meals, the fiber, the low saturated fat foods, and a step-by-step roadmap, comment guide below. We'll send you our free recipe pack designed to reduce liver fat, improve insulin sensitivity, lower fasting glucose naturally. You don't need extreme diets. You don't need to starve yourself, and you don't need to fear carbs. You just need to restore your liver's ability to respond to insulin again. Comment guide below, and we'll send you everything.